Hey everyone, welcome back to my second channel here. I know I haven't been updating things as much as I had before I was doing it once a week. Now it's like once every 2 or 3 weeks. This is how it's going to be for now, just because time is limited and some of these projects are a lot bigger. I mean, there's a big project sitting right here and with an engine that needs to come out, but for now I'm kind of just focusing on some basic stuff. I'm trying to do some maintenance on my Tiburon, and I want to show you guys some of the small changes that have been made over the course of the past few months. I've been driving it for a while now. I'm really enjoying it. There's some things I don't like about it, but that's okay. I feel like I need to take care of it properly either way. So yeah, let's get to it. So as I said, today we're going to be doing an oil change. I've already taken off the engine cover. That's more of a permanent thing. And the honest answer is because I like the look of it without. The engine cover is hanging up there, not to ever be used again. But yeah, so I was checking the oil today and I noticed that it was a little bit low and it's very brown. So I went out and I got some stuff for it. No, this is not sponsored by Quaker State. This is literally just what was on sale. So let's go. I want to show you what the oil looks like currently so we can have a base comparison. And keep in mind the car is cold. This car calls for the car to be warm when checking the oil, so that means the level is going to be lower than it would be when it was warm. When I checked it, it was warm, so I know that it is a touch low, but it's going to look extremely low is what I'm trying to say. Well, it was really having a hard time focusing, but this is what the oil looks like currently. There's just a little bit of it on there, and it does appear to be quite brown from what I'm seeing. So that's kind of what made me think to change it. Like when I bought this car, it had no service history, so I have no idea when it was changed last. I probably should have done this way at the beginning, but anyway, let's try it. Okay, that was my first time doing that with a manual, and it was actually pretty tricky to keep it from rolling back and also to balance the clutch and the gas. So I'd install, and I also was able to get them up there. either way, we're good. These ramps make things a lot easier. I just gotta put some chocks back there. It just happened to start raining immediately as I'm doing this, so time is now of the essence. Although the longest part of this is going to be draining the oil, so I'm gonna chalk the car and get on that. Let's see what it looks like underneath. Got my oil bin here. Got my beautiful rolling cart that I lay on. It's literally just a piece of a fridge box. And let's go under there and see what this looks like. Okay, so there's the engine side of things. This appears to be a cover, although I didn't know this car had a cover. And it looks like the oil filter is up in behind there. So I'm gonna have to blitz this lad off real quick. I'm not sure. Oh, yeah, Quaker State. That's what we're replacing. So I got some safety glasses on. It's a little crusty under there, but this is the oil that's coming out. It's pretty dark. So I discovered, don't mind the hammer, that it's a 17 mil, just an easy wrench on the end of there. Pretty easy to do an oil change when there's only one cover, but the thing was gross and it's really rusty. So I'm not sure if I'm actually gonna put that back on or not. But let me show you what we're working with underneath. Slightly leaking. I'll just let it go. Move that forward. I actually haven't spilt any oil, which is miraculous. I feel like I'm going to though when I do this, because awkwardly, the plug is on the back of the oil pan. It really should be right here. Like, I don't know why it's not here. Or right here would it be even better. Because then, if it's here, the filter is right there, so it just drains easy. But obviously, they have different ideas. So, time to pop this lad off. I have an oil filter wrench, partially because I'm weak as heck and I need stuff like that. But yeah, I just want to match up the new filter to this old one before I take it off. Just to make sure that I'm not making any mistakes here. So, some excellent news. The old filter is the same as this new one, exactly the same code on it, which is nice. Makes it easier for me. And it cleans up nice down there, no issues that I can see. And the car isn't leaking any oil, which is miraculous. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of oil from the brand new jug and I'll put some on this, and then yeah, we'll throw it on up there. I know that that's not necessarily something you have to do, but I don't think it's gonna hurt. I've done it with pretty much every oil change I do, and yeah. So this car takes 4 liters of oil, and in this case I bought 5. So I have a little bit more than I need, but better to have more than to not have enough. So all I'm doing is I'm greasing the seal on it, and then I just have a cap full of oil, just dump that in, and then there we go. Throw it on up there and we're good. A gang of Honda Civics just drove by, but anyway, so here's the old stuff. There's the old filter that's gonna go in the bin, and this stuff will eventually get recycled. I basically am just filling up this jug slowly with all of the oil that I have, and then I'm gonna empty it out into some of my very copious amounts of extra jugs. I happen to have a few Pennzoil jugs in here, and soon a green one will be joining, but it's time that I filled this car up. Super easy to do. Just what you want to do if you've never done this before for your car is check the owner's manual to see how much oil it takes. I think I mentioned this before, but it takes 4 liters. I have 5, so I'm gonna put in probably 3.8 or something, let it sit for a bit, take it off the stands, and then double check afterwards to see if it's where it should be. I don't want to put in too much, I don't want to put in too little. It's got to be right in that sweet spot on the dipstick. So yeah, let's do it. Just gonna let the car run for a bit while it warms up, and then once it's warm, we'll check the oil again, make sure it's good, and I'm gonna clean up. All right, oil change is done. Everything is looking good. Just waiting for this to drain, but yeah, she finished. Thankfully, it came up nice and clean, and I checked it a few times, and it's right just under full, so I figure that's pretty decent. Stepping into the car, I wanted to show you guys. Well, for one, we now have a record, 173,000 kilometers. This is actually, no, this is not the highest kilometer car I've owned. My old Subaru, I think I got it up to 210 or something before it rusted away. Thank you, Ontario, for that. But this is a custom piece made by one of the members of our community. Will 3D printed this for me, and I just wanted to give him a shout out. I've been shifting with this for a while, and it's pretty darn awesome. It also has the Bugo inlaid on it, which is sweet. So, yeah, thank you, Will. So with that, I bring this video to a conclusion. Thank you for watching. Yeah, the Tiburon, I mean, not much really going on with it. I have ideas, but I've been driving it daily, so I don't really want to go crazy with things. I'm really lacking in the maintenance department. I've got a lot of grand ideas of things I want to do. It's like engine swaps, turbos, all this, and then it's like, wait, I gotta do the basic stuff first. Sometimes you gotta swap the oil. Otherwise, it's not going to go for long. I took my Infiniti sedan out for a quick drive today. That was actually when I went to go get the parts for this car. And it makes me really sad. It's sitting right there. It makes me really sad that it's sitting doing nothing. So I'm kind of considering either selling it, or I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it. But it just makes me sad to have it sit out here. And it's that kind of sadness has me motivated more to get rid of my Coupe Infiniti. I need to get rid of a lot of parts from it. I haven't been very successful the past month basically selling stuff, mostly because I've sold most of the desirable items and everything else is just kind of everything else. I'm about halfway to the budget back, but I still need some time to get through it. The weather lately has been hot. It's been very demotivating. I don't really do very well in the heat, and especially in the sun. I just don't cope with the sun very well. So to be able to work in those conditions is difficult, even in a garage. Obviously, I don't have AC in the garage. So yeah, I don't know. It's a nice cooler day today, but at the same time, I'm not really sure where to go next with that car. And It's bothering me a lot that it's kind of just stuck in the garage. So I figured a small win today would be a good thing. But anyway, that's a bit of an update for you guys. Thank you for watching. I'll see you again next time.